black people. It's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving. Warning. 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 Warning.
Warning. Stand by for countdown. Prepare audience for maximum impact. Full immersion begins in.
To achieve liberation. Like Angela Davis said, it's built into the system.
Nowadays I can't believe what's going on in front of me. I don't want to watch TV and find another casualty. I don't want to read the news. My heart's already black and blue. I'm putting on my combat boots, 'cause I got an attitude. Like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done. And don't you even ask me, when did I become such an angry black woman?
We can't successfully put an end to racial discrimination until we change the entire system.
We've been trying to keep the peace 50 years since Martin King. Some don't like me for who I am, but I love my melanin. Another future college grad sleeping in a body bag. Mother screaming out her lungs, she never gonna see her son. We're like soldiers forced to fight a war. What the hell? I can't take it anymore. 'Cause for so long we've been patient, now we're done.
It's not growing. Just keep it going.
They see something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Shamsuddin? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Nobody takes down and the Snuff Nuff 7 easy. There's a reason why, after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuff Nuff 7 is still here. There's a reason why nobody wanna get in a beef with Angel Snuff Nuff 7. But you don't take me seriously.
Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this.
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am. 'Cause it's all about control. And I've got lots of it.
And I've learned Breaking news, breaking news. I guess this would be anything about it. But I did see a post from Dr. Umar Johnson, and I saw some other talks. And it seems as though the Nation of Islam or Louis Farrakhan organization, the Final Call Incorporated, it seems as though finally they have filed suit against this Jewish organization called the Anti-Defamation League. And the Anti-Defamation League has used their influence, their media, to basically claim that Louis Farrakhan, the Nation of Islam, are anti-Semitic. And I believe, what is it, the southern part of Farrakhan and the Nation of Islam as a terrorist organization, a hate group. And this is fine. This is fine. I remember when I was in the ranks with Minister Farrakhan back in the day. I remember It was Madison Square Garden, 1982, I believe. 81, 82, somewhere in there. And we were having a meeting. And the mayor of New York, I forgot what his name, I think it was Mayor Koch. He told black people, do not attend the meeting. You need to stay home because Farrakhan is a hate monger, anti-Semitic, and all this other nonsense. He told them, he telling them, you stay home. Don't go to the meeting. And the response from the black community, Soul Brothers and Sisters of New York, it made them want to go to the meeting even more. We had to open up buildings next door and put loudspeakers on the outside. And the only thing that the mayor done was made black people want to go see what's going on even more. And so on the outside, myself and other Fruit of Islam is the military wing of the Nation of Islam. We were outside, and across the street from the venue were members of the Anti-Defamation League and probably some other Jewish organizations, whatever. They were on the outside with protesting against Farrakhan, saying, who do we want? Farrakhan. How do you want him? Dead. Who do we want? Farrakhan. How do you want him? How do we want him? We want him dead. And I don't know. You would seem as though that would be something like a terroristic threat in and of itself, but nobody bothered them. You can go around in the public. How do you want so-and-so? We want him dead. So I guess that's permissible. I guess it's according to who you are. So these persons, the Jewish Defamation League, and in fact many others, have made a claim that Louis Farrakhan is anti-Semitic. He's a hate monger. Now, for me, there are those who might see this video strange, but it's not strange when you understand I have to stand with what is right. Now, you can claim anything that you want. It's all right for the Jewish Defense League. It's all right for the Southern Poverty. Southern Poverty, whatever the hell. It's a lot of these organizations that call Soul Brothers and Sisters, our organizations, terrorist organizations, that we are hate mongers and all this foolishness. You can say whatever you want to, but this is the great thing about America. The great thing about America is you can take people to court for defamation and slander. We did that last year or this year. I forgot what it was. We went to court for defamation and slander. That's the great thing of America. So you can say anything that you want to out of your mouth. Now, if it's true, no big deal. But if it's not true, you have a problem. What's her name? That rapper, Cardi, what's her name? Cardi B. She took that YouTuber, Tasha K, to court. Won $1 million. I don't think that Tasha K has paid that woman her money. But she lost the case for slandering, defamation of character of Cardi B. So I can guarantee you, Tasha K is going to be real careful in how she talk about other people. That's the wonderful thing about America. This should have been done way back when I was in the ranks. The Nation of Islam should have began to sue these folks. Make them go to court. Make them prove their allegations, because Louis Farrakhan, whether you like him or not, that's not his thing. He's not anti-Semitic. He's not a hate monger. That's a damn lie. Now, when it comes to Malcolm X back in the day and in the early 80s or 90s or whatever, that's different. And Malcolm's family should have took him to court for slandering their father, defamation of character of their father. The Black Panther Party, I wish they had stayed on that course. The Black Panther Party went into the law of this nation and found a loophole so they could carry guns. And then these suckers had to go in and change the law so that the Black Panther Party could not take advantage of that loophole anymore. I want to talk about this, and I think it's wonderful that the Nation of Islam would sue these folks, because they need to be sued. The thing about a lot of Jewish people, they put themselves in this self-righteous victim category where you can't talk about them, because some Jewish people smoke, they drink, they commit adultery, they commit murder, they do many things that other folks do, but because I'm part of the Holocaust, and you cannot even question the 6 million victims of the Holocaust. They cannot be questioned. You cannot talk about this particular group of people. They are very protected. So we need to take them to court. What makes you so better that you can't, nobody can't point out what you do? Because here we are, the descendants of slaves born in America, victimized. Who knows how many millions of us died in this nation? And they talk about us, call us out of our name every day. Nobody's protecting us. We're not protected. But this group of people, if you question them, then you are anti-Semitic because you question their behavior. I question the behavior of Israel over there. Not because I have real concern because of what is right and what is wrong. We get information that's one-sided here. So let's go to court. The Black Panther Party had it. You had it going on until they became blackity black. Instead of using your brain. You're living in a nation where you don't have weapons of mass destruction. And even if you did, I don't know if you would use them anyway. But you're dealing with a force that is more powerful than yourself. But see, everything has an Achilles heel. Everything has a weak spot. Target. The head is a good target, but also the throat, the middle of the chest, nerve points, the groin, the back of your What is that part of your leg? It's a lot of areas that you can attack instead of always just the head, because folks are going to protect their head. But see, it takes a lot of energy. When you try to protect your head, all this other stuff is open. But we don't think about that. Everything has an Achilles heel. Everything has a weakness. A diamond is one of the strongest materials on this planet. But it still can be broken down and polished and manipulated. Something can still destroy it. Something can still cut it. Although we look as though we're weak in this nation, and you are weak from a military standpoint because you don't have weapons. You don't have tanks. You don't have AK-47s and missile defense systems. You don't have all that. But these people have an Achilles heel. They have weakness. One of their weaknesses is their court system. One of their weaknesses is their political system that you don't take advantage of. You don't take advantage of because you listen to all that blackity black crap like they have weapons of mass destruction. And the little guns and things that these blackity black folks do have, they're not going to use them. They have yet to use them. So what the hell are you listening to them for? See, I cannot come on YouTube and tell us what we could really do. And we don't have to have guns. You don't have to have a nuclear bomb. You are here. Do you know how many enemies of America wish they live here and could be here? You live here. Many of your relatives work in many places. But we don't take advantage of none of these things. Even our economic power, we don't use that no more either. And it will work, but now we're so comfortable, and we have not taught our children to love themselves. They think everything is over until we have a George Floyd now and then. So they don't care, because we think that the war is won. We think we are in this comfortable place. And you're not.
Keeps it real like that. I keeps it real.
But you in a position where you can get your respect by taking advantage of the things that your enemy give you. And the Black Panther Party was a prime example of what to do. This lawsuit should have been filed a long time ago. Now, the dangerous thing about it is, I don't know exactly how this worked, I don't know if it's if they filed it under the Nation of Islam being defamed or Louis Farrakhan, because if it's filed under an individual, just Minister Farrakhan, and not the Nation of Islam itself, then, well, actually, the damages is against Minister Farrakhan, because there's a whole lot of Nation of Islam factions out there, different one. This also is sort of dangerous for Minister Farrakhan because, well, we already know that he's an older person. So if he mysteriously should die, what happens to the lawsuit? See what I'm saying? He dies mysteriously. And who's going to question it because he's an older person? And he's been fighting cancer for, what, over 20 years. So if he mysteriously died before this lawsuit can go to trial, who benefits? So I don't know exactly how this lawsuit has been filed. But we need to understand that there are a lot of tools at our disposal if we use our brain and, like the Black Panther Party did back, search the weakness of your opponent. This is what we must do. This is what we fail to learn because we're listening to all these idiots talking like they have tanks. They waiting on the God to do. What do you think God gave you brain for? To solve your problem. That's what the brain is for. To help you solve your problem. It may come a time that you have to physically get down. But we know right now we're not in a position to do that. So we're going to have to move smarter. More wiser. And again, I can't come on here. And plus, also, I know that there are many people who steal your idea and take it for their own. So there's a lot of things that I just cannot say because I would have these folks, they steal your ideas. They steal your vision. And really, that's all right, far as I'm concerned. But they want to turn it into something that is not. They want to use it for their own gratification and glorification. They don't want to use it for the purpose that it was revealed to us. This is why the Mississippi campaign is important. It has never been done. And everything about the Mississippi campaign is legal. So in order for them to do anything detrimental against the activity of the Mississippi campaign, they'll be going against themselves. Because everything that you do is legal under their law. There's nothing really they can do. Even if they start changing the law, they'll start having problems. Not only with soul brothers and sisters, they're gonna have problems with their own because this is an attack on American political system, democracy itself. So what you're basically doing is you're taking the political system hostage, hiding behind it. So when they attack, they're attacking themselves. They're not really attacking us. They're attacking themselves because you say in this country, this is the rights of the citizens. This is protected under the United States Constitution. So the Nation of Islam, or any of us. We need to take the suckers to court. Since you making these claims against me, then you need to go to court and prove it. And like young Pharaoh told brother, that pedophile brother Polite, give me my bag. And the Nation of Islam and Minister Farrakhan is asking for $5 billion. Give me my bag. Those people cannot prove that Louis Farrakhan, the Nation of Islam, is a terrorist organization. It cannot prove that he's anti-Semitic. But when you're able to run your mouth, you can say anything that you want to. Proving it is a totally different ball game. I was in court with some folks not too long ago, and they claimed that I slander and defamed them. And I said, well, you defame and you slander me. And the court said, both of y'all guilty. So the thing about it is, even if the court case turned out that way, which it's not, because Minister Farrakhan never talks about, never slanders. He does not talk about the Anti-Defamation League like that. So I want to see them prove that Louis Farrakhan or any black organization that they claiming anti-Semitic and all this other nonsense. Because you're a human being. Jewish people are human beings. And they make mistakes. They smoke, they drink. Some of them eat pork, break a violation of their own religion or whatever. Guilty of domestic abuse and so many other things. So many things, but you can't talk about. See, the thing about defamation and slander, if it's true, you don't have a case. But what these people are saying is not true, yet you cannot prove it. They cannot prove what they're talking about. You need to take them to court. They should have been taken to court long time ago, and they would have shut up. Oh, they still would have been on your case, but all that, oh, you a hate monger. Oh, I took, in 2009, I believe, 2010, I took Google to court, almost won. Because Google, they flagged my channel still. They still harass me. But they never talk about hate speech no more. We went to court and I asked them to prove to the court that I'm speaking hate speech. And they couldn't do it. The judge said, what hate speech? The judge did not see any hate speech. It's a damn lie. Just harassment. Now, it's amazing how a corporation, I only get 10 views. I only have 10 subscribers. This big corporation, Google, still gonna find it necessary to harass me. 100 channels terminated. What kind of crap is that? That should tell you something. Hate speech. I don't hate nobody. Slander and defamation, hate speech, if it's true. But if it's false, give me my bag. Like young Pharaoh said, it's lies. Because of Google and maybe even Facebook, you can't even talk about certain folks on social media because it's hate speech. And they did what you're
talking about. I cannot even talk about my own gender. Oh, you hate black men. Hate speech. That's a lie. I'm a male myself. I cannot talk about my own gender and I'm telling the truth. If I'm not telling the truth, take me to court for slander and defamation of black men. They're not going to do it. Folks don't like you to talk about their skeleton. Folks don't like you to talk about when they wrong. Hate speech. Well, prove it then. You don't know how much power you have just in the court system. If we use just the court system, these people and their discrimination and their murder, oh wow, you just don't know the power you have. The political system, these black power idiots, because they don't understand the power that you've been given. There's a reason why these folks shot us, jailed us, try to stop us. Why do you think they would do that if voting had no power for us? Why would these people go all out of their way to kill us, to try to stop us from voting? They know, you don't know. And you said because you have not been able to use it in the right manner. But they understand if you're able to use it to your benefit, they know the power that the vote has. They know. You don't know. And so you don't vote and you don't take people to court. You just holler and scream, black power, hotel, I say, and all this other nonsense that you got from all this Pan-African garbage. And what do they give you? What have they produced? Not a damn thing. So you keep listening to them. And you keep walking on their road to nowhere. Because that's where they're going, on a road to nowhere. I wish Louis Farrakhan, I wish the Nation of Islam the best of luck in this lawsuit because it's needed. And I hope that they win to show you that you're not as powerless as you believe, to show you that there's a lot of tools at your disposal that you're not taking advantage of. Because you're not listening to the right people. As long as you give them your money, they don't give a damn about you. They talk about their bag, their million-dollar house and their cars, and they don't care about what's happening with you. So they could care less. And then they pass their generation of wealth that they got off your back to their children. Your babies ain't gonna get up nothing. They're not gonna benefit. All these organizations, including Louis Farrakhan, Nation of Islam, none of those assets go to the believers, go to the followers. You ain't gonna get nothing. You're not gonna get nothing. So, the Nation of Islam was worth $80 million when Elijah Muhammad died. How much did the followers get? Nothing. Because if the followers got it, those heirs, those his family members wouldn't hardly have nothing to argue and fight over. When Yahweh... fell apart. It was worth $100 million or more or whatever. The followers got what? They didn't get nothing. Malachi J. York, whatever his damn name is, what did his people get? Y'all didn't get nothing. So Elijah Muhammad said in the lessons, why do black people, why do the so-called Negro love the white man? Because he gives you nothing. And you happy with nothing. And you make excuses because you didn't get nothing. Oh, well, it was all about Allah. Allah didn't get none of the money either. Yahweh didn't get none of the money either. All the money went to Yahweh bin Yahweh, Elijah Muhammad, whoever these the leaders of these organizations. God didn't get nothing. You didn't get nothing. Only the family got nothing. You get nothing. If the believers, if the followers of Elijah Muhammad actually own something in the Nation of Islam, at least the intellectual property, how could it fall into public domain? Because you own and run nothing. I refuse anything associated with me in regards to the Mississippi campaign. You're gonna know that you got something. Even in Marcus Garvey group, they sold stocks. So you have a piece of paper in your hand just so that you can at least say, I'm a stockholder in these ships or whatever they was doing in the late 20s and early 30s, whenever. You're happy with nothing and make excuses, and you proud to have nothing. How sick. Somebody told, it's a lie, I have not seen a proof. I'm happy to say something different. They told me that followers of Louis Farrakhan have interest in the assets of the Nation of Islam. The Nation of Islam belongs to them. That's a lie. I was in the Nation of Islam. Where my part? Well, you're not a part, no. So, okay, I'm not a member no more. I still should have some kind of stock. I still should have some kind of share. I helped build it. And I have family, and I asked them, where's your share? I thought that this lie, because it's a lie until proven otherwise. It's a lie. There's no proof. There's no evidence to show that the believers own the Nation of Islam property. These properties are in the names of Farrakhan or his wife and children and whatever. I can guarantee you the believers don't own nothing. You should be sick of people exploiting you. You should be sick of people taking advantage of your kindness. You should be happy, or you should not be happy to have nothing when you sacrifice. Look, I know some of y'all sacrifice. Some of you mortgage your house. You don't drive the kind of car that you really would like to drive because you sacrificing and you suffering for the cause, but you're not suffering for the cause. You're suffering and sacrificing for the benefit of an individual and his family. And your family don't get nothing. No, that's wrong. I couldn't even sleep at night. Living in a big house. Getting millions and millions of dollars. And I know that some of you can't even pay your electric bill. And you sent me your last pennies. To do what? To do what? And you make excuses for having nothing. And you call yourself an adult. But you wouldn't tolerate that on your job. You go to work on your job. And when Friday comes, where my money? And if that person don't give you your money, there's a big problem. When you pay your electric bill, the electricity better be on. Hey, wait a minute. Where my internet? I know I paid my internet bill. I paid the gas. What's up? But you tolerate investing in these people that you call divine, and they give you nothing. If it was up to them, you would have no gas, you wouldn't have a car, you wouldn't have the internet, you wouldn't have nothing. Because they give you nothing. How long are you going to tolerate this? It's wrong. And you will get angry at me because I'm speaking out because you like them. Who cares because you like somebody? Because you like somebody don't pay your bills for you. Because you like somebody don't stop your sons from being shot down by the police. Because you like somebody. Because you like somebody don't stop your daughter from being raped or become a stripper. There's a problem here. So I'm the one with the problem. Angel Snuffing Up 7 is crazy. Because I want to get paid. And if I serve God, I'm going to say this in conclusion. And if I serve God, I need to get paid. I'm not going to wait to die to get a reward. You need to start showing me that you can do some stuff for me, God. Because you know I don't have weapons. Then you need to bring your ass out here and fight for me. God has yet to come out here and fight for us. We get shot down here in these streets. We are discriminated against. We are made mockery of. We've been enslaved. Our ancestors have been enslaved for over 300 years. This God has yet to step up and do anything for us. And you still loyal. And you get nothing. How long you going to tolerate that? How long are we going to tolerate being mistreated? By God? By the oppressor? By these immigrants? Everybody mess with us. The buck has to stop somewhere. It needs to stop now. Stand up and be a man. Stand up and be a woman. Take matters into your own hands. If God helped you, that's cool. But I don't need you no more. If these other Africans or whoever these other people, they claim they stand with you, we don't need you. But if they helped you, that's cool. We can handle our business. We know how. You're not going to get nowhere messing around with these magic people. These people live in some kind of fantasy and delusions. You have a lot of power. There's a lot of advantage that you have. You don't understand your potential. Again, I do wish the Nation of Islam, I wish Minister Farrakhan, I wish them success and win this lawsuit. It's time. And we need many, many more for these idiots running their mouth. If it's true, no problem. But if it's not true, and you can't prove it in court, give me my bag.
Everybody who is black and interested in black people, let us sit down and find out how we can get together in one direction against one enemy and accomplish this job overnight.
When soul singer and black activist Sam Cooke wrote the lyrics to his song, A Change Is Gonna Come, it was very direct and to the point. With some changes to it, the song was still digestible. In the year 2019, black folks continue to go through the change rather than direct the change. A community activist named Talik Ibn Rod has made an appeal similar to what Sam Cooke was asking for. A change. It's said that the meek shall inherit the earth. We ask when. When will the landlords give the meek a free lease? Mr. Ibn Rod is humbly asking for the state of Mississippi. This is Dusty Basement Studios, and we approve of this message.
The Mississippi campaign represents everything that you claim that you want. The beginning of an all-black independent nation. The ability to control your own resources. Your politics. The law. Be able to do your own thing for a change. Create an economy. Create and produce goods that Africa or anybody on the planet would want. You're fake, you don't want to do nothing. 3 hours talking about the Mississippi campaign.
Trying to get this, trying to walk 3 miles a day. So far, doing pretty decent. Then I want to probably start running 3 miles a day. Try to get back into the best health I can do. Yo, Twin Pyramid, what's happening? What's happening? Thank you, brothers, for your support. Thank you for always being here. For the old geezer. So, I just want to make this quick commentary. Now, look. This is how stupid folks are. I'm gonna stop here real quick and make this commentary. Okay. Now look. This is how stupid people are. Okay. If you're walking around in the woods, and it just so happened you run up upon a bear. Now, you don't have a gun. You don't have a knife. What do you do? Do you challenge the bear? Raise your hand. How many been in that situation? Or if you walk down the street and a pack of dogs come out of nowhere and you have no weapons or anything, do you challenge that pack of dogs? I mean, raise your hand if you do. I mean, some of you might be brave enough to do that. Me personally, even if I have a weapon, I don't want to face a bear. Yo, what's up there, Mellow Cap? I don't want to face a bear. I don't want to face a pack of dogs. Like right now, I'm on my walk. And when I go on my walk, I carry a stick. I carry some kind of weapon because they're stray animals, or there might be stray humans that think I'm a defenseless old man. So we're gonna have to show them real quick I'm not as defenseless as you think I am. So, now most people with common sense, I say that again. Most people with common sense, they would try to avoid a confrontation. That's what they would do. Most people with common sense. But as you know, in the black conscious community, in this genre that we find ourselves in, soul brothers and sisters, African Americans, whatever the hell they want to call themselves nowadays, they're not very bright. That's why they're always in trouble, because they don't learn nothing. They don't have common sense. They don't know how to reason. They have no logic. Everything is based on emotion. How you gonna challenge a bear with no weapon? How you gonna challenge a pack? I'm not talking about one dog, I'm talking about a pack of dogs. I mean, even one dog is a threat. But using the logic and the mindset of these folks, they would do that. They would challenge the dogs, they would challenge the bears. And then end up in the hospital or end up in the morgue. Stupid. So on Facebook, there are those idiots who interact with us. Angel Snub Nub 7, Reality's Temple on Earth, internet platform. Now, we may appear like everybody else, but as you know, we're not like everybody else. So for them to approach me is like approaching a bear, approaching a pack of dogs or some other vicious animal, because they have no defense. But they're gonna do it anyway. As you know, then they look real stupid. That's not your fault. That's not my fault. They have no common sense. They don't use reason. They're not analytical. They're emotional. They get upset because they don't like what we say, but there's nothing that you can do about it because that's reality. It's the truth, real truth. I'm not talking about the plain truth. I'm not talking about a part of the truth, half truth. I'm talking about the real truth, facts to the best of our ability. And you know you don't have nothing coming, so they get their ass whooped. And if you are one of those who are stupid like that, you're welcome to come to our platform and bring your supreme wisdom, your knowledge, or whatever you want to call it, and get your ass whooped. It's simple as that. You don't have nothing coming. So when they get upset, it's redundant. They say the same things over and over again, trying to
defend their outdated, archaic mindset, which has produced nothing, which is going nowhere. It's like trying to put a round peg or a square peg in a round hole. It can't be done. They keep trying because that's what they like. They're emotional. And they believe that they have some kind of supreme wisdom. Now, you would think after 100 years, you claim you have supreme wisdom, but you have done nothing supreme. You have black power, but you have no power. You have not produced any power. Common sense tells us something is wrong. But of course, they don't have common sense. The only thing they have is emotion. And they have a church mindset. I have hope and I have faith that one day things gonna change. But in reality, if we don't change it, nothing happens. That's the reality of life. That's the reality of all life. If we can't change it, it don't get changed. There's no supreme being. There's no ghosts and goblins gonna come and help us. It's not gonna happen. So I don't know why I am a bear. You think with the stuff that you copied from somebody that you was taught by a foreigner, you think that you could do something with me. So they always bring up the same old redundant argument trying to defend themselves, because they know they are part of failure. They are not successful. I don't care how you try to make it look. Success does not have to be explained. If you are a champion, you are a champion. You don't have to explain it. It's quite obvious. They have to explain their success. They always have to point fingers to something that happened 5,000 years ago, 2,000 years ago, 1,400 years ago, 100 years ago, because they have nothing today that they can use for an example. So, one of the redundant defense arguments that they always use with us: what you doing for black people? I don't see what you doing for black people. You're the one that claimed to be a messiah. You're the one that claimed to be a savior. You're the one that claimed supreme wisdom. You're the one. I don't claim supreme wisdom. I don't claim to be a messiah. The only thing that I claim is we offer advice and suggestion. That's all I can do for you. I don't owe you nothing. I don't owe black people nothing. Black folks are grown. You're grown. You're grown men and women. I don't owe you nothing. The people that owe you something are the people that you give your money to, and the one that claim they are your savior, they have the supreme wisdom, and they are the messiah. I don't claim that. I don't owe you nothing. Period. Now, if you take my advice, if you take our suggestions, and you act on those principles, then I owe you to help you, to help us. I'm not your leader. Nobody voted me for to be their leader. So I don't owe you nothing. You have gave me no money. I owe you nothing. You need to talk to those who make you a damn loser. Those who claim to have supreme wisdom and have done nothing supreme. Those hollering black power and don't have no damn power. You need to talk to those people. Those people that talk about they are a savior and a messiah. You need to talk to them. You don't need to talk to us. Oh, you're nothing. The only time or the only person I owe is me. Or my children or my wife. I have no wife. I have no children. I owe nobody nothing. I only owe me. It is a blessing that you would have somebody like me to be able to come to you and give you another strategy that you can use.
Peace forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire at reality's temple. Reality's temple. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody moving me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire.
Yes. I want that. Ooh, I need that. Got to have that.
Your blessing. And whether you know it or not, you even prayed for me to come into existence. You prayed to God for me because you need an answer to all this. But when God gives you an answer, you ain't ready for it because it does not come to, in the form that you believe it should be. That's your problem, not mine. The scriptures say, or talk about in reference to the God, my sheep know my voice. When you listen to me, you can hear your God talk through me because remember, your God can use anybody. Your God is all powerful. And your God chose me for this message to see if you recognize him. If you can talk spiritual, I can too. And you see why you're not getting anywhere. Here you are, This is the answer to your prayers. And you don't recognize. You don't want to recognize because it's not coming in the manner that you feel it should come. That's your personal problem. Don't blame me. I have nothing to do with that. And the reason why you can't recognize the answer to your prayers because you don't use common sense. You don't use logic. You're not analytical. You don't have a critical thinking mind. You're loyal to foolishness. You're loyal to emotional rhetoric that has gained you nothing. You've been going to church all this time. And what has it done for you? You have been Black Power all this time. And what has it done for you? These things have done nothing for us. Common sense says, if it don't fit, there used to be a song with those lyrics. If it don't fit, don't force it. But you're trying to force it. It don't work. It's not meant to be. So don't get angry at me. Don't look at me. I'm not your leader. Talk to those who you give your money to. Talk to those who keep you on the real road to nowhere. Talk to those who have really sold you a pipe dream. That's who you need to talk to. I don't owe you nothing. You're a grown man, you're a grown woman. If you want to be a loser, that's your business. If you want to win, we are here to show us and guide us to being winners. Because I don't like losing. Man, if you don't mind being losers, I have a problem with that. I don't like being a loser. You don't mind being a loser as long as you can feel good about losing. I don't want to feel good about coming, being number two. I don't want to feel good about being number 30. I want to be number one. And I understand that those things in the past are not going to help us become winners. This is 2023. This is a whole brand new day and time. And we got to get with the program of 2023. So it's up to you. I don't owe you nothing. What you need to do is get on the soul train. I invite all of us to take the time and come and join us for our main lecture of the year. We call it Soul Liberation Day 2024, December the 7th, 2023. The theme is Free Your Mind, and the rest will follow. You're comfortable with these little knickknacks. These little nothings, the little money, the little praise that you get from these little knickknacks, the little success that these personalities give you, it's nothing compared to what you can actually get. You don't understand what's waiting on you if you give all these things up. You can't even comprehend it. I'm not talking about fantasy. I'm talking about it's realistic in your lifetime, because you're gonna make it happen. But you can't make it happen with these strategies and the mindset that we have right now. Proven. It's obvious. Don't call me a liar. Don't call me crazy, because it's obvious. It's obvious. It's obvious. Get on board the soul train and let's be successful. But I don't owe you nothing. If you want to win, you got to do something different. You want to keep going to church? You want to keep going to church and feel good? That's your business. We have the message, we have the plan that can work for the people. Because it's designed for the people, not for me, for the people who are different. We're not all the same. We're different. But we are in a similar circumstance. And those other things that you personally want, you can get that after you get the main problem solved. But see, you want what you want when you want it. This personal garbage. And see, that's where the main problem is. What you want personally. You're not really interested in what's good for us as a people, what you personally want. And guess what? You personally ain't gonna never get. You're not gonna get that. Cause hell, most of you don't even have your own, you don't control a neighborhood. You don't control a city. Well, we know you don't control a state. You don't control nothing. Personally, your little organization, your little cliques. You can't even personally do that. But if you care about the people, then you're gonna have to submit to what the people want. Because if you don't submit to what the people want, they're not going to help you. It's 40 some million brothers and sisters in this country. They're not interested in your religious based black power crap that you believe in. They're not interested. They're not. They're not interested in what I'm talking about because they are spiritual and a lot of them are spooky. They're not interested in that either. But Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign is not about what I personally present. It's not that at all. The Mississippi campaign is about what is in the best interest of this people who deserve better. And God has answered your prayers and brought you better. In fact, I would say it is these blackity black type people that's the enemy to your resurrection. These blackity black religious-fied people, they are the ones that's keeping you from the promised land. Because they're stuck in a past that they never lived. They are in the way with their fantasy and their fairy tales. Then they have the nerve to talk about Jesus. I have a better opportunity, a better chance, and I know and I have gotten treated better with my black Christian brothers and sisters. And I definitely, no Christian has ever threatened my life. The only people that get angry and upset and talk about want to kill me is these blackity black type folks. I've never been threatened by nobody in the Christian church. To my knowledge, nobody in the black Christian church has murdered our leaders, to my knowledge. I know that one woman, she stabbed Dr. Martin Luther King. It had nothing to do with religion. He was a troublemaker as far as she was concerned. Leave these white people alone. Leave things the way they are. And that's the way you are. You're not really ready for change. You're really against people who really want to change. And in order for there to be change, something's got to go. Something's got to give. Or be part of the change. These folks don't want to be part of the change. Because they still want to be racist. There's no place for racism, whether it's black or white, in heaven. There's no place for it. When you blackity black, you're nothing but a son and a daughter of white racism. You would not exist if it was not for white supremacy. This is a fact. None of this that they're talking about, if it was not for white supremacy, none of it would exist. This is a fact. None of these teachings, none of these beliefs existed before white supremacy. It comes and it's a product of white supremacy. And I would tell you, I'm going to conclude, that's the reason why they really can't fight against white supremacy, because all that blackity black stuff is white supremacy. That's why they really can't fight against it. What are they going to do if there's no racism? If there's no blackity black, there's no the white man do this and the devil. What are they going to do if there's no God, no devil to fight? If there's no white man or no devil to fight, what are they going to do? What are they going to do? And see, with us, we taking all that out of existence. The white man, the devil, all this foolishness. It has no place in a new world. So with that said,
peace forever and always. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire at reality's temple. Reality's temple. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me. Like at the King, we make it plain and simple. Bringing knowledge and fire. My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody.
In a state of emergency. Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
Keep it real.
What, dear?
Because I keeps it real like that.
I keeps it real.
Again, I don't owe you nothing. We don't owe you nothing. So I don't know why these folks keep putting that in my face. You ain't did a damn thing for me. What the hell I owe you for? Save you for what? Malcolm X and Dr. King, all these saviors, Harriet Tubman, these generation run around, talk about them like a dog, have no respect for nobody. Save you for what? No, you need to go to the hell that the Bible talks about, the Quran talks about. You need to go to hell. Good riddance to bad rubbish. Be glad when your ass gone. You don't deserve life. Save these suckers so they can turn around and talk about you like a dog, pretending they can do better. There are those who talk about, I can do better. I can do better than Dr. King. I can do better than Malcolm. I'm better. How long they been on YouTube? Lots of money. In a better position than Malcolm or Dr. King was. What have they done? Done nothing. Save them. Save. I'm not your damn savior. You need to go to that hell. And that's what you're gonna get because you're a hell raiser. Hell raisers deserve to be in hell. Because that's what you give. And even these suckers that keep talking about peace, they hell raisers. There's nothing peaceful about them. They skin and grin in your face because they want something. Give me your money. Give me your booty. They want something from you. But if you don't get with their program, they will show you the devil that they really are. I don't get angry with nobody because all of you deserve and you have the right to your opinion. And I cannot expect everybody to be on my level of thinking. I don't get angry with you. But I will tell you, because I'm guilty too. There are those who are warners, who have our best interests in hand. We don't want to listen. And then we have to suffer the consequences. So the only thing I can say to us is, you're going to suffer the consequences. It's simple as that. You're going to suffer the consequences. So, for every action that we do, we're going to have to suffer the consequences of our actions. It's simple as that. And unfortunately, in this situation, it's not going to be looking good. I understand that all stories don't have a happy ending. But we can change that. And all scriptures don't have to come true. We can change these things. Scripture only come true because the prophets understood the mindset of the people. And since we understand your mindset, we can prophesize what's going to happen to you. Many of us, we prophesy. If you're dealing with a crack addict in your family, and that person don't want to let go of the crack, it's not rocket science. You can prophesy what's going to happen to them. And that's all what prophecy is about. It's about a behavior and guessing what's going to happen to somebody because they are walking in a certain direction. So the Quran says or tells us, and you ask according to the Quran, you ask Allah, oh Allah, guide us on the right path so that we don't have to suffer, so we don't have to face these things, so we can make right decisions. And I am humble enough to say that Allah has answered your prayers. Yahweh, Yashera, whatever you want to call the Supreme Being, the Most High, your prayers has been answered. You don't recognize. And when you do recognize, it might be too late. I would suggest to you to get on board the Soul Train and let's get this to moving up. And you can begin by coming and spending time with us, Soul Liberation Day, December 7th, 2023, at 2:30 p.m. free your mind, and the rest will follow. Try to think about it, if you can.
And as always, in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul.